You're listening to Good Morning Gwinnett, a division of Noise Media Network, hosted by Audrey Bell Kearney, sharing stories about people and places around beautiful Gwinnett County, Monday through Wednesday at 10 a.m. and Thursday at 11 a.m. Southern living at its best.
Good morning, all my Gwinnettians out there in Gwinnett land and all of you around the world listening to the sound of my voice. It is a beautiful day here in Gwinnett County. I'm talking about lovely, y'all. 75 degrees going up to a high of 86 and sunshine for the whole weekend. I'm talking about the entire weekend. That's a lovely. I know it's, some people got another day left. Today is my weekend. My weekend starts today. And it is beautiful. I'm excited about that. I'm excited to be here with you this morning. Got a great guest with me this morning. Been trying to get her on the show. She's a busy woman doing amazing things. And she's going to be here with us after I get through my horoscopes and all the good stuff that I do. Hope you're having a great day. It's National Corn on the Cob Day now. I don't even like corn on the cob, but I know there's some people that love corn. So if you want, now listen. Corn is a starch, just so y'all know, but you can still eat it. I think some people think it may be a vegetable. I don't know. Check that out. Don't go corn crazy, but it is National Corn on the Cob Day. So go ahead, get you some corn, enjoy yourself, get you a nice piece of grilled corn, some cream corn, however you want to eat it. I don't like corn. You know how I eat corn? I'll eat it just a little bit. If I go to Chipotle and they put like the salsa with the corn stuff in, that's the only way I can eat. Like I don't eat rice. The only way I eat rice is in sushi. Like, I'm weird like that. I don't eat cornbread. I'm weird like that. But anyway, I ain't going to talk too much today at the top of the hour because I got a guest and I want to bring her on. I've been trying to get on now for probably about 5 months. And she is a busy woman doing amazing things here in Gwinnett County. I'm so happy that she's my guest today. So let me go ahead and kick off our horoscopes brought to you by noted astrologer Michael Thyssen. Today is June the 11th. It's Thursday. You made it over hump day. Now it's Thursday. And we're going to kick it off like we always do. And that is with Aries. Aries, consider selling your homemade crafts at the flea market. Extravagance will be a problem. Make sure all of your travel and driver's documents are in order. Make sure your papers are in order, especially if you're trying to travel today, Aries. You trying to go somewhere, make sure your papers are in order, okay? And sell your stuff at the flea market. I don't know if the flea market is open yet, but you make some handmade crafts, go ahead and sell them. If that doesn't work for you, check out Etsy. No, Etsy is not paying me. I just know it's a great platform to sell homemade craft items. I just know that because I'm an entrepreneur. Taurus, strengthen your position among your peers. Take time to find out all you can. A long discussion is in order if you wish to clear it up. Listen, if you got some stuff going on, talk about it. A lot of times that's the issue. People don't communicate well. So Taurus, you want to clear it up and clear the air, you need to talk about it. Don't sit there and sit on it. Let it stew. Let it make you mad. Talk about it. Get it out your system and then get it over with. Don't sit there and hold on to it. You hold on to crap too long. And then the only person miserable is you because you're the only one holding on to that junk. Most people have moved on. They're doing their thing. And you're still miserable holding on to something that pissed you off years ago. That's dumb. So don't do it today, Taurus. Let it go. Talk it out and let it go. Gemini, you can get your point across and make valuable connections. Empty promises will cause upset. Take time to listen to other members. All right, listen, Gemini. Listen today. You don't talk. You just listen. Don't you say a word. Just take some time to listen to what they have to say. Maybe they need to clear the air, so they need to talk to you. Could be. Never know. Cancer. Real estate investments will pay off. Be aware that you might be at fault as well. You should want to feel good about yourself and your goals. Yeah, Cancer, feel good about yourself. Feel good about your goals. Set some good goals. Feel good about yourself. Do something nice for yourself. Yes, do that. It makes you feel good. Leo. Do something that will be stimulating and creative. It might be best not to spend your money on luxuries today. New relationships will surface through work-related events. Hold on to the coins. Do not try to go out there spending money on stuff you really can't afford today. And you might have some new romance on the horizon at work. Now, I don't know how your work policy is, but just know you may have one. So if it's like you got one in the policy, don't date on the job. Heed that warning, y'all. I don't want you to lose your job. Virgo, you may blow a situation out of proportion when dealing with the one you love. Family outings should include visiting friends or relatives. Camping, swimming, and biking expeditions should be considered. Let me tell you, I was in Helen last week. It was beautiful. I wanted to go water rafting, but I didn't bring a swimsuit. because I was like, I'm not getting in the river, but the water was so clean. I could have done it, but it was not water rafting, tubing. It looked so much fun, so I'm going to go back and try that. All right, listen, I'm going to a song. I'll be back after the song to finish up the horoscope so I can bring on my guests. So just stay tuned, y'all. Welcome back, y'all. Listen to the Good Morning Gwinnett Show. I'm your host, Audrey Bell. I'm giving you the daily horoscopes brought to you by noted astrologer Mike Thyssen. We're going to pick it up with Libra. Channel your energy into projects that will enhance your home. Romantic opportunities will be plentiful if you go out with your friends. You'll be emotional about your personal life. Uh-oh. Listen, go on out. Have some fun. If you want a romantic life, go out. Have some fun. Don't be so emotional. Just have some fun. Scorpio, don't let an incident at work play on your mind. Plan a nice evening for two. You will have no problem getting your point across to those in a position to help you. Plan a nice evening for two. It's a beautiful evening, especially in Gwinnett. It's beautiful today. Go out in the park. Have a picnic in the park. In the dark. No, not in the dark. But just go ahead. Go do something nice. Sagittarius, you may feel that someone at work is holding you back. Don't overdo it. You will do well with clients today. Listen, watch your back, Sagittarius. If you feel like that person is holding you back there in a position of management, go to them and let them know, listen, I'm trying to move up and you're in my way. But don't say it like that. You know, you got to be diplomatic about it. I'm undiplomatic a lot of times. Don't say it my way. Say it the right way. The right way for your job. I'm just saying. Capricorn, finish off old projects before starting something new. Sudden changes regarding your domestic scene are probable. Uncertain changes regarding your personal life are evident. Oh, you got some personal stuff going on too. Hopefully it's some good changes for you, Cap. Hopefully it's some good stuff. Hopefully it's not bad stuff. Aquarius, you don't owe anyone an explanation. Do your thing. You need the time for yourself. Yes, take some time for yourself. You will be popular and easily attract members of the opposite sex. Use your charm, but don't sign or agree to anything. Charm them, get them to where you want to be, but don't sign nothing. Listen, don't, you know what I say all the time. Especially don't sign if you don't understand what it is. If you don't understand what it is, hire a professional to help you out, okay? Somebody you know and trust. And my fellow fish Pisces, you can make headway in the workforce if you put your mind to it. Be careful not to reveal private information. You can persuade even the toughest opponents to think your way. All right, fish, I don't know about y'all. I ain't even in the mood to try to persuade nobody to think my way. Think your way. I'm going to think my way. I'm just saying. I know some fish are trying to persuade folks, not me. I ain't in the mood for all that. It's a good day. It's a beautiful day. That's all the horoscopes I got for you, y'all. I'll be back again on Monday because, you know, today is Thursday at 10 a.m. to give you more of the horoscopes brought to you by noted astrologer Michael Thyssen. But now let's get on to my guest of the morning. So my guest today is Miss Penny Poole. She is the president for the Gwinnett chapter, NAACP. And I know she has probably been super busy because there has been a lot going on. I'm happy to have her this morning. She is a mother. She's a wife. She's been a resident of Gwinnett County for 39 years. She's out there on the front line fighting for the African-American life. And I got some stuff to talk to her about. So, Penny, thank you so, so much for being my guest today and welcome to the show.
Oh, thank you for having me. It's a privilege. Thank you.
You're welcome. So I know you've probably been busy, but before we get into all the stuff that's going on right now, tell us a little bit more about who you are and where did you come from? I know you've been here in Gwinnett for 39 years and you've been fighting for civil rights for a long time, but what was your background before you became an activist for the NAACP and the African American community?
My parents both are from South Carolina. They migrated to the New York area. I was born and raised in the Bronx. But we lived like South Carolinians in the Bronx in a tight family knit community. So Southern culture and Southern heritage was always instilled into me and my six other siblings. So we grew up with just a pride of South Carolina, black people, heritage, food, speaking, culture.
Now let me ask you this, because I've heard this said before. Like, my aunt was married to a guy from South Carolina, and I was a little girl, and I remember them saying, yeah, he's a Geechee. What is a Geechee?
Well, it's a culture, it's a heritage, it's a way of life. We have a language, we have food, and certain foods that we eat. It is a mindset. It is the people who were enslaved from Africa, brought over to South Carolina coast. Most of these people, and even though Savannah is a Georgia city, Savannah's a Geechee city. So all the way from Savannah up to north of Myrtle Beach, we find people who call themselves Geechee. And we are of West African descent. And we have words that are still built into our language that came from West Africa, as well as British words, because it was the British who also settled and developed those areas of South Carolina, North Carolina. So wrecking is something that my people would say. And you don't think of it as a British word, but it is. When you hear people say wrecking, mm-hmm. It comes from the British. When you hear people say akimbo, it comes from the language of West Africa. So my
So you got the southern, you got the southern side, then you got the boogie down Bronx side. So you got it all. You just, you got it all. And then when did you come to Georgia?
I came to Georgia in 81. And newly out of college, looking for a change and adventure. When I graduated college, I went back to New York, but New York was not the place that I left. Being away from there for 6 years, it was the beginning of the crack epidemic.
Mm.
And as people on the streets were saying, everybody was cracking up. The Bronx that I grew up in was a Bronx that was clean. You didn't hear about gang violence. If it was on your block, you just didn't accept it on your block.
Mm-hmm.
My father was a super, so our block was clean. Our buildings were clean. We had some of everybody. So this Bronx that people stereotype now, that's not the Bronx that I grew up, knew, or was ever a part of. And the Bronx that I knew was family. We had a family church, and everybody in that church somehow had the same culture and black background as we did, because we had Sunday dinners with collard greens and sweet potato pie and potato salad when we had programs. So my life, even, you know, being raised in the Bronx, we were transient, I guess. We were South Carolinians living in the Bronx.
Wow, that sounds, I'm sitting there, that was a great story. Because as you were telling, I could feel myself in the Bronx on the block, on the bricks, as they say. You know, I was born in Georgia, but I was raised in Newark. So I talk about Newark a lot because it's a part of who I am. It made me who I am because it made me, you got to be strong. You know, you're living in the inner city, you got to be strong. You got to be able to withstand some stuff. And it has made me who I am. Now, when did you get into activism? What was it about activism that made you say, you know what, I need to be a part of this. I need to do something. I mean, that's really a lot of activism going on there. So now let's come to present day, because I know that you have a lot going on. I want to get to some of the stuff that's going on right now. We're in Gwinnett County. I'm going to start with the most recent thing first, and that's the voting. The voting that did not happen and the mess that was. What can we do about that, Penny? Because I think about 2016, what happened then. I think about, you know, when Stacey ran, what happened then? And here we are back in the same place we were, you know, 4 years ago with this whole voting situation. And the powers that be just don't want us to have that right. That's how I feel. What's your thoughts on that?
Well, you're very true on that. That's called voter suppression. constitutional amendment. So this is not new. This is a continuation of the past with the enslavement of our people.
So I know that there's a bill that they're trying to put out, the anti-voting rights bill. What, do you know anything about that bill, State Bill 463?
We've been talking with a lot of the representatives. I do not know the mechanisms of it. I've gotten a lot of information on it. The state capitol opens up on Monday. I plan to be there. So by then, we will be supporting, because I know we are supporting these at the state level as well as the local level. So we will be on it, but we are supporting its passage. And another thing, I meant to say previously, things that we could do, because you asked me what we could do to avoid these circumstances.
Mm-hmm.
Because even before we get a state bill, what we first must do, we must make sure that we are registered to vote. And that's the first. And then after we make sure that we are registered to vote, then we need to check our voting status. And we check our voting status by going to mvp.sos.georgia.gov. When you put your information in there, it will show you your precinct. It will give you a sample ballot. It will make sure that you know what precinct, again, you're supposed to vote at. So just doing those two things would eliminate 80% of the problem. But the third and most important is to vote early.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you vote early, there's now the absentee ballot request that you can request a ballot, and they will mail it to you. And after you mail it, get it, you can mail it in. So that would avoid long lines. So then there's the other thing, to vote in person and early. They had 19 days of early in-person voting. You could hear crickets in a lot of those polling sites.
Yep.
Myself and Representative from District 105, House Representative Donna McLeod, we personally fought with the Board of Registration and Elections since 2013. To make sure that we had early in-person voting. And these days are supposedly to get people in without lines, without headaches, so that you knew that your vote would be counted. And then, and if we do all of these things, this would eliminate any type of shenanigans that they are trying to hold or have to stop this systemic voter suppression here in Gwinnett County.
Yeah, because I know when the fairgrounds opened up, they were like in a 10-hour span of time, there were only 92 people who actually came to vote. Now, my question is, how is that information being disseminated? Because do people know that they have early voting at these locations? Because I talked about it. I talked about the locations. But I feel like now, moving forward for the election in November, I need to talk about it more. We need to figure out how to make sure people know that early voting is going on. Because the polls were open, and Gwinnett Fairgrounds is right by my house, and 92 people on one day came in, and that's nothing. So what do we need to do to get the word out more? Like, is there ads that need to be run? What needs to happen for people to know that they don't have to wait? I saw a young lady on the news, and I applauded her because I felt like she was serious about voting. She was sitting in a chair. It was pouring down raining, and she had a baby. She had an umbrella, and she was like, I'm not going anywhere. I'm going to sit right here until I can vote. That's a good thing, but not everybody is like her. And so what else can we possibly do to let people know when early voting opens up that you don't have to stand in the lines on the day of voting? You can go and vote early and miss the line. Because it was like 92 people in a 10-hour span. That's nothing. That's like nine people an hour.
Newly created community outreach system. whereas here, we do not have these systems in place. So because we know that this is a suppressive state and they are trying to hamper our vote, we need to take proactive measures. And proactive measures, we know that these elections are happening. We need to make this, and we need to prioritize this. And that's what's not happening on our side. Yes, we need the government to let us know, but we have to make this important. And that's what we have not been doing. We only make things important when people have to die or ask.
Mm-hmm.
Let's not have to have people die to make something important. Let's do it before then.
And that's so true. And I see all the movement that's going on around George Floyd's death, and that was a horrible thing. But it got a lot of people in motion. It got a lot of people to start saying, you know what, enough is enough, and I'm tired of it. So there was a lot of protesting. And we're gonna switch gears just a little bit. I got to tell you this story. I don't know if you read it in the Gwinnett Daily Post. I think it was Monday or Tuesday. The chief of police in Johns Creek. He started out saying, you know, I'm protesting and I'm a Christian, but he then said that the clergy and pastors were slacking on their duties. They were letting the people down. And I was like, okay, let me keep reading the story. So his gist of the story was that the pastors and the clergy were letting people down because they are part of the Black Lives Matter movement. He was saying that because they are a part of that movement, he don't think they should be a part of it because the movement is really a disguise for something else, and that he needs to dig a little bit deeper because that movement is saying, you know, kill his brothers and sisters. That's what he said. And I was like, what is he talking about? And then he goes on to say in a letter, this letter was posted on the Gwinnett Daily Post, so anybody who wants to go back and read it, go to the Gwinnett Daily Post. I think it was on Monday. Go back and read it on Monday. The whole letter is there. And he goes on to say that one of the officers came to him and said that this was happening in her church or his church. I don't know, was it a girl or a guy? And so he jumped on the side with the officer saying that the clergy and the pastors were neglecting them, were leaving them behind. And I said, that's the kind of mentality in my mind. Had I been in a position of authority like him, and I had an officer come to me and say, my pastor is leaving me behind, I felt like that person should have like a mental evaluation, because if that's how you're feeling, that's how people get killed. So if you feel like the Black Lives Matter movement is out to get you and not what it really stands for, then the minute you go out on the street, you already have some built up animosity, some things going on in your head that they're out to get me. Because that's pretty much what she said. He or she said, they're out to get me.
That what they are trying to do, they being And Drew Brees didn't need to know he was a racist.
Right, and
he had to let Drew Brees know that he was a racist because his white privilege has let him say these things all these years, and he didn't even realize how offensive he was in his language. So the conversation is not black people talking to black people. The conversation is white people talking to white people. If you are a moral man, if you believe in a Christ, if you believe in God, and I'm not proselytizing now, whoever your God is, your God would not allow you to hold your knee on someone's neck for 8 minutes and 46 seconds without thinking that you would not be reproached, without thinking that you are in public on the street and that you would not be held accountable. So the root of all of these problems is racism, white institutionalized racism, and it needs to be called to the carpet, and it needs to be called to the carpet now.
And you know, Penny, that's a sad thing. Like, they really don't know that they're racist. Like, they think, when I read that article, I'm saying to myself, what exactly, and here's my thought. If there is some information that you know that's deep down where you want the pastors to go dig, bring it to the surface. If there's something else behind the Black Lives Matter other than what it really is, it's about us losing our people, bring it to the surface. There is nothing in the back of the allegation that you're saying that is something deeper than that. You got to get to the deep. I'm like, and in my mind, I'm thinking, so this person gives you this information based on what? The way they feel? Like, was there anything to back it up? I doubt it very seriously. And so to me, you don't even know. Just like you said, he said a lot of good stuff in the beginning. But then he sided with this person. I said to myself, he doesn't even know he's just like that person. Like, they don't even know they're just like the person with the neck, the cop with his knee on the guy's neck. Like, you don't even know because you think I'm a Christian. Because he said I'm a Christian, you know. And I'm thinking, but you're contradicting what you said. You know, and I talked about this. It pissed me off because I'm like, this is the type of thought process that will cause somebody else to get killed. This process right here, because if you have officers on duty and they're out there in the field, and the minute someone does anything to them, the first thing in their mind is they're going to get me, so I'm going to get them first. Because that's what you're saying. He was like, my brothers and sisters. I'm saying to myself, who are your brothers and sisters? Are they not black and white? Or are they just white? What does that mean? Are you talking about just cops and nobody else? And I said, there were thousands and thousands and thousands of white people marching for the exact same thing. Are you saying that they're saying, hey, come kill us? Because that's what you're saying.
Well, when I use the verbiage that I use, the first people who come up to me and say thank you, it's not the brothers and sisters, it's the white people. It is the white people who are coming up to me and saying, thank you, Penny, for saying that it needs to be said. Thank you, Penny, for exposing that it needs to be said. Thank you. So this knee on the neck mentality is that I can do anything and will not be held accountable because I can snuff out the life of this African-American black person because their lives don't matter or count and no one will care. And that knee on the neck mentality must go immediately. And it only will start when the white people tear it down. We can't tear it down. They must tear it down.
Now, Penny, let me ask you this. You said the people that approach you are white people saying thank you. Thank you for sharing. Thank you for bringing it to the light. Do you think they knew it already and were afraid to say anything?
Of course. I had a teacher who worked at a school. She was afraid to talk to me. And I let her know that, you know, I would never reveal her without her permission. But what she told me, what she sees, she works in a school. The racism at the administrative level daily, and that there's nothing done about it, and that there is. And then I had another they are, the positions they hold, the decisions they make that affect our children and our lives each and every day.
And, you know, I say this all the time, and, you know, I'm by no means a perfect person, but here's the thing. If you are afraid and you call yourself a Christian and you see things going wrong, all you got to do is say to yourself, hey, would Jesus do that? Because that's gonna clear it right up for you. And if your answer is absolutely not, then you need to say something. You know, being afraid and watching somebody lose their life, that's not Christian. Jesus wouldn't do that.
Well, what I did yesterday when I was at Belleville on the green, I equated it to evil. Because there, you know, the Bible says that we wrestle not with flesh and blood, but principalities, evil in high places. So for Chauvin to put his knee on George Floyd's neck, that was nothing but pure evil. For him to suck the life out of someone. So I equated it to evil.
Mm-hmm.
So there were many religious people in the crowd, and I wanted them to look that squarely in the face. Are you on the side of evil?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Now, I know you've been with the NAACP for quite some time. Please tell us about your experience there, how long you've been there, and for people who don't know what the NAACP is, what does the NAACP do, and how can they get involved with that?
Well, to be honest, I have not been a long-time member of the NAACP.
Okay.
Talking about Gwinnett County Public Schools. relationship wrong. And we are reigniting this Gwinnett NAACP to work for and with the people of Gwinnett County, especially the African Americans who do not have a voice in this county right now.
Wow. Wow, wow. Well, thank you for your work. Thank you for the work you're doing. I am inspired. I when I was in New Jersey, I was a member of the NAACP, and I will be joining this NAACP real soon, probably in the next couple of days, because I feel like there's a lot of work that has to be done. We have a really important election coming up, and everybody has to do their part. Everybody. And we cannot sit back and be afraid. We got to step up and do what we got to do. I use this platform as a way to disseminate information about this community and to also shine the spotlight on those who are doing great things. It's not about race. It's about the people of Gwinnett County. I moved here 7 years ago, and I love this place, and I'm glad to be a part of it. But I also know that there are a lot of inequalities, and, you know, we want to be in a place where everybody is equal. And, you know, and now that's going to probably be a fight for another 400 years, but I'm here to help fight the fight and walk the walk and talk the talk. So thank you for doing all that you do. Now, I know you got to go, and we're right at like 45 minutes. How can people get involved, contact you, and how can people get involved with the NAACP?
Okay, thank you for that. And I thank you for the work that you're doing, because having this media outlet is tremendous. But if people are interested, we are all volunteers. We do not get paid. So we need your financial support. You can donate to our organization. And then secondly, we need your physical support. People, we want you to work in the area that you are comfortable. If it's with giving your time, your talent, your dollars, we can accept any of the above. You can go to naacpgwinnett.org. That's naacpgwinnett.org. And you can join, become a member. Our Facebook page, we are making sure that we're putting information out there. As a matter of fact, there was a new incident that happened at Collinsville High School that everybody is really enraged about. And we need you to call, you know, the school board. There was the yearbook where an insert was made into the yearbook calling Dr. King, Martin Luther King Jr., my nigga. So I want y'all to find this because it's circulating and we'll be posting it.
Wow.
But this is in the Collins Hill High School 2020 yearbook where they asked the students to take selfies because when time ran out, they were unable to finish their yearbook. So this particular student took a selfie with ML King in the background. I'm going to go read it for you because I want to make sure.
Please do.
I have it.
That was actually on my list of questions, but we didn't get to it. But please do. Go right ahead.
Okay. What this thing says is official and hyphen word tag assigned to Michael Garcia, and his last name is blurred, and it's given by Black Beach Knicks, and that he has a scribble of Martin Luther King's signature under it. So I'm going to read that again. It says official, he has holding up a paper. It says official N-word pass assigned to Michael Garcia, and his last name is blurred, given by Black Beach Nigga, N-I-G-G-A, and it starts out with an M, and he scribbled Martin Luther King Jr. I will send it to you.
Okay.
I'll text it to you, but it's a picture of him. And then he has a picture of MLK Jr. in there with him, with his hand on his shoulder, with his nigger pass.
Wow.
And this is in the 2020 Collins Hill High School yearbook.
Wow.
So we have a long way to go. And these conversations of insensitivity and feeling that people can say anything. This is a knee on the neck situation. And this is what I'm referring to these instances as knee on the neck instances where people are blatantly and publicly doing instances without thinking that they should be held accountable. should the student, but the principal at the school should be held accountable for this.
Yes, absolutely. Well, thank you so much for being my guest today. I really appreciate it. And we gotta have you back, because I'm sure it's going to be a lot more going on right now, because we're about to go into this election, the big election. And, you know, we have a lot of work to do for that as well, because there needs to be some changes at all the way to the top. And we need to make sure that people know when early voting is and where early voting is going to be, and if the ballot is filled out right, and can they do it at home. Like, all of that stuff needs to be known. My mom and my uncle are both senior citizens, and they don't get out to vote because they both have disabilities. So we made sure, not only did we fill out the ballot at home, the mail in, we texted in, we emailed it in, so we wanted to make sure our ballot reached here. Not everybody's going to do that. Not everybody even know they should do that, but that's what we made sure that we did. We made sure that the ballots were mailed in, and they were also emailed in. Because I heard yesterday on the news that they lost 8,000 ballots. How did they do that? I have no idea. No idea.
Well, the process for those ballots, you have to request the ballot first. This time they sent it to us because of Corona. And then after you receive it, you fill it out, then they will mail that ballot. You can only mail or deliver a ballot. So emailing does not work. Is not, your ballot will be destroyed if you try to email it in. So the only way to do that is to mail it. If they have the drop boxes out again, put it in the drop box or physically take it in to the polling place day of the election, or you can take it into the Board of Registrations and Election located on Grayson Highway in Lawrenceville, Georgia. And please, if you would check our media for the times of early voting. Again, I just want to reiterate, please vote early. Please vote early. And first, before you even vote, check your voter status at mvp.sos.georgia.gov. And when you check that status, you put your first initial in, your last name, your county. It will let you know that what precinct you are at. That was one of the biggest problems during the election day. People were changed. Their precinct was changed at the last moment. And they were given provisional ballots, is what they were told. And that's even a whole nother conversation. But you want to cast a ballot. You do not want to use that provisional ballot unless it's your last result. Because with a provisional ballot, you have to go back in and prove that that is your ballot and your voted identity. So you would have to go in 3 days later. The verbiage that was used by the poll managers, because most of them were so confused and not properly educated, this should have been a ballot, an emergency ballot, than the provisional ballot. You want to make sure that if this happens again, you're using the ballot or the emergency ballot. Now, they have been changing this conversation constantly, fluidly things have been changing. Please go to trusted websites, GwinnettNAACP.org, our Facebook. We will have all these schedules up when these schedules are released. The runoff, please, please get to the runoff. The runoff will be August 11th. We will post the days of early voting for the runoff. Again, August 11th. For those races that were not won outright on yesterday, please go back and vote in the runoff on August 11th. There will be early voting as well as day of in-person voting. And there will not be time for ballots. So we're going to have the instructions. Or let me take that back. We are waiting instructions on how they will be handling this, how to request absentee ballots, because this information is not known yet. So because of Corona, because of social spacing, because we are not able to accommodate those at one time inside voting, website. And most of all, please check your voting status. Those two things, they will also give you sample ballots. So, thank you again. Thank you for having me.
You're very, very welcome, and thank you so much for sharing. I feel your passion through the microphone right here. We're gonna make sure we do everything we can to get the word out there so people know that, you know, the county fairground is open and it's huge and there's nobody there standing in a line. So we're gonna make sure we do everything we can for the runoff and for the general election in November. So I will be doing my part as much as I can. I will be joining the NAACP as well to do my part there as well as the Eastside Chamber in Gwinnett. So I got a lot I got to do too, and I'm going to do it. So, but thank you so much for being a part of our community and fighting for everyone. And thank you so much for sharing all this great information with us and explaining to people what Geechee means. Because I mean, I've heard it. I didn't know what it meant. My uncle was a Geechee, so thank you for sharing that information as well. Listen, you always welcome to come back to this show, and I'm going to be live streaming with video pretty soon next month, so I would like to have you back again when we go live with video. We'll be streaming to Apple TV, Android TV, Fire TV, and Roku, so stay tuned for that. Thank you, Penny, so much. Listen, guys, hope you enjoyed my interview with Penny. I'm going to go to my song, and then I'm going to come back and give you my inspiration before I wrap it up for today. Thanks, Penny. Enjoy the rest of your day and your weekend.
Thank you, and blessings to everything you do.
Thank you so much.
But I don't dare to, I'm too fragile, and for that I do apologize. Maybe someday we can work it out, but I'm afraid it's too late to try. Baby, I don't dare to love you, and you know the reason why. Don't you know I'm way too weak to swim? Can't you feel the waves come crashing in? Running out of safety nets, cause every night, every night. Maybe someday we could work it out, but I'm afraid it's too late to try. Baby, I don't dare to love you, and you know the reason why. Don't you know I'm way too weak to swim? Can't you feel the waves come crashing in? Running out of safety nets, cause every night, every night. Hey! I fall down in the middle of the night screaming, oh my God, cause you love too deep. You know you love.
right, welcome back. So listen, guys, that's all I got for you today. But before I go, I want to give you my word of inspiration. But before I do that, just remember, if you like this show, share the show with your friends. Follow me on goodmorninggwinnett.com. Also, you can follow me on Facebook at Good Morning Gwinnett, on Instagram at Good Morning Gwinnett, and on Twitter at GM Gwinnett. Also, go to iTunes and give it 5 stars. The more stars I get, the more Apple puts me up in the rankings, and I need those rankings, y'all. I need those rankings. So if you like this show, share it with your friends. Download the app from the app stores. That's the Apple App Store and the Android App Store. So we're on both platforms. You can get us on both platforms. Be sure to support the show. You can go there and get your Good Morning Gwinnett Sunrise Coffee by going to goodmorninggwinnett.com. So that's all I got for you today. But before I go, I want to just give you a little word of inspiration. It's such a beautiful day, y'all. You know, today is my Friday. Your Friday starts tomorrow. Mine starts today. Some of you started yesterday. But here's my word of inspiration for today. And this is a really good one. It says, remember, you don't need a certain number of friends. You just need a number of friends you can be certain of. Let me say that one again. Remember, you don't need a certain number of friends. You just need a number of friends you can be certain of. Ain't that the truth? A lot of people want to have a lot of friends. You just need a couple of good friends that you can be certain of. A couple of good friends that you can really call friends. A couple of good friends that got your back no matter what and you got theirs. That's a good friend. I'm blessed. I call myself blessed because I feel like I got quite a few good friends that I know got my back, that I know that I can trust in my life, and I appreciate them. So to all my friends, to all my listeners, thank you all. Thank the listeners for listening. Thank the friends for supporting me. Thank my family for loving me unconditionally. Sometimes I could be a handful, y'all. Just a little bit. Thank you all for just sharing this show and listening to the show. I'll be back again on Monday at 10 a.m. And Thursday is our new time. I forgot to announce it yesterday. So somebody's going to tune in at 11 o'clock. They're going to get Penny, but it's going to be recorded because I forgot that we started at 10 o'clock. So starting moving forward, every Thursday, the show will air at 10 o'clock live, just like it do Monday through Wednesday. So we can be on a schedule because we're about to start live streaming the show as well via video. So we're going to get all that in, get out there next month. But right now you can listen Monday through Thursday at 10 a.m. And I'll be uploading my new intros to before Monday so you can get the new intro. So now it tells you 10 a.m. All right. Well, anyway, thank you for listening. Listen, you're going to go out this weekend. It's still beautiful. So stay safe out there. Corona's still out there. She's running around, y'all. She's still out there. So be safe. Enjoy yourself. And I'll be back again on Monday, God willing. Until next time, make it a great day. Bye now.
You've been listening to Good Morning Gwinnett. Make sure to tune in Monday through Wednesday at 10 a.m. Eastern Time to find out what's happening around Gwinnett. If you missed an episode, go to www.goodmorninggwinnett.com to catch up. If you liked this episode, subscribe to the show now and share it with your friends. To learn more about Noise Media Network, visit www.noisemedia.us.